This week, we're going to see an epic battle play out between free market capitalism and big government socialism. That's what's at stake. And clearly, when you see Speaker Pelosi's actions over these last few months, it's been to massively grow the size of government to appease her radical socialist base. And I think you're seeing the American people across the country express their anger and frustration because they're paying the cost of it already with higher inflation. Inflation's through the roof for so many things that people buy every day. Gasoline's up over 40%. When you go to the grocery store, you're paying 30 or 40% more. If you want to buy a new appliance for your house, you're going to wait months and months and still pay a higher cost for it. So President Biden's already broken his promise that his actions will not impact the paychecks of people making under $400,000 a year, because the hardest working Americans and the lowest income Americans are the ones paying the biggest cost for the inflation already created by President Biden's failed agenda. And now they want to double down on it and put it on steroids. This would be inflation on steroids, tax increases like we've never seen before in the history of our country. The package that Speaker Pelosi is still trying to bring to the floor this week would be over $5.5 trillion of new taxes and spending, much of it added straight to the deficit, all under the name of leveling the playing field. Tell that to hardworking families who are already paying too much in taxes, who know that, for example, President Biden's energy tax in this bill, a tax on natural gas, is a new tax. It would hit the lowest income families the hardest. It would probably add about 14% to everybody's household electricity bills if they use natural gas. That is a violation of President Biden's promise to those workers, in many cases, who make less than $50,000 a year. They're going to pay a higher cost for President Biden's agenda. We actually tried to take that tax out of the bill, and on a party line vote, every Democrat voted to continue charging new taxes to families on their electricity bills. It would hit hospitals too, increasing the cost of health care. We tried to protect hospitals from having to pay these higher taxes, which will be passed on to families in the form of higher health costs, which, by the way, would be another violation of President Biden's promises that your health care costs wouldn't go up. Over and over again, we've seen broken promises, and the American people are fed up. That's why we are fighting against all of this radical socialist spending and these new taxes that are going to hurt families in America, that are going to be a gift to countries like China,